Hi guys, Dr. Leon here, and in this video for YouTube product reviews, we're basically going to do a Google Sites factory review. The ranking factory guys have put together a new Google Sites builder, and it's really, really good. Basically, we've taken what we've learned over the last few years with Ranking Factory, and they put it into a new format, which is faster and quicker to build the Google Sites. And there's a lot of upgrades and advantages in this particular G Sites builder. The thing we need to think about for just a minute and know, if you don't haven't heard, is that there's two Google Sites, what we call the old Google Sites and the new Google Sites. And the old Google Sites have been around for years and years, and they're going away. Actually, you can't even make an old Google Site anymore. And as of this coming September, they're going to be archived, and they won't be around anymore. If you haven't converted your old site to a new Google Site, you need to do so before September. Otherwise, it'll be archived, and they won't be there. So our builder works with entirely just the new Google Sites, has nothing to do with the old Google Sites. And it's rather exciting because there's, like I said, some advantages in here. We'll walk through this in this G Sites factory review. So let's take a look here. Basically, we add our accounts over in this section tab. And then when you've got them in there, you just drop down and pick the ones you want. And it's pretty simple and smooth. Put your title in here. And then when you've got everything filled out and you've actually run the software, your URL will show up in the published URL section right here. But let's take a look at what we have to do right here. It's really pretty simple for the most part. You just click the pages you want, like homepage, about us, privacy page, contact us. And when you get to contact us, then you will have things you can fill in, assuming you want to fill in any of these, just click them. And then any additional pages you want to build up to 6, you can just click on them and put in the titles here. So it's pretty straightforward with that part. You do have the option to choose whatever themes you want to use. And once you've chosen that theme, then it becomes what we use to select our font. And so you have the option for the font once you get your theme selected, and then you just click on that. And then we put our images in here for like our headers, footers, and body images. You can put all the images you want here for each of the pages so that they're all ready to go. So you have to have a title, and you have to have the images you want to use, and have them the size right, which is around 1200 by 400. And then basically you're ready to go over to the next part, which is this tab here. We can put spin text articles in here. And the nice option we now have is that you can actually even use HTML in spin text content format, so that when you put your HTML in here, it will show up in the Google site as HTML. And so you now have that advantage if you want to make use of it. But once you hit spin, then all of your content will be filled out for each of the pages that you've selected here. The privacy page has its own content, but and then of course the contact us will have whatever you selected. And then your optional pages, where the content will be filled out here. And what you have to select is like your header image, your body image, and a YouTube URL if you're going to use any of those things. Now, the nice feature that has been added and is really sick is we now have the ability to put in up to 5 embed codes. So you can put in one, and then a second one, a third one, a fourth one. And so that is really slick in here, is you can just drop your embed code in here, and when it creates the site, it will put those embeds into the Google site. So we have that available, as well as you can adjust your content once you've taken out a spin text, and make sure that it kind of looks the way you want it to look in there. We also have the ability to use the splash image, which is a very, very, very large image for those that may want that option. So that's something that is there as well. And on the homepage, we can put a link that we want to link out from the Google site as the header link. And of course, you select your image, header image, body image, and you select a footer image right down here as well. And you can link out from the footer as well here. So you'd put that link in here. And then your images show up down in this section here. So it's pretty straightforward and simple. And if you want a YouTube URL, each of the pages, make that available. So you can put a YouTube video on any of the pages or all of the pages that you want one on. And so that makes this rather quick and easy once you just have a few links, whatever you're linking out to. Then, of course, your image and your embed links, and then, of course, your spin text content and your titles for like the optional pages and your web page title. And you're ready to go and build your Google sites really quickly, really easy, pretty simple. Now, there's another little advantage up here in that if you want to build the site but you don't want to make it public yet, we actually have that option right here. It's called upload. And so everything that you put in there will be uploaded and built, but it won't actually be made public or published yet. And so that's an option you have. Then if you want to have it published, you would click the publish button and it will upload and publish it. So you have two options there as far as uploading, as the ability to upload it unpublished can be an advantage in some situations and allow you to do more things when you get over there. And you have it in place and ready to do. If you want to put more stuff into it later, it'll be ready to go, and then you can publish it from there manually. And then we also have the ability to save everything you put in here. And if you've saved it, then you can hit load and it will actually bring up the sites that you saved, and you can hit on those and reload them again, and it will put everything back in there. With one exception, it won't actually put the spin text in here, but all your original content will be in here. And so everything is saved with that, and with the exception of your contact information. It doesn't save that, but other than that, your entire site can be saved, and you can make any additional changes you want later, change titles, page names, whatever, and drop your new spin text in and run it again for whatever you need to do. So this is a very quick builder. It actually allows you to make Google sites rather quickly, simply and easily. So it allows you to stack Google sites, to make PBNs out of your Google sites. There's just a lot of advantages to the Google sites. You're primarily using them for the most part to send link juice somewhere. And so this makes it very quick and easy to do so. And that is pretty much the review for Google Sites Factory. So I want to thank you for watching the Google Sites Factory review. And if you're interested in picking this up, please click the link below the video. That's where you'll be able to pick up the Google Sites Factory. It's available and ready to go. It will be a launch somewhere down the road, but right now it's in pre-launch, in beta mode. There's more stuff that's going to be added to this. And the one additional thing I really need to mention is this is going to be the Google site builder that's set up for when Google actually has their API. We're actually in line and waiting for when they release the API for the Google sites. We will be one of the first people to have it in this Google site builder. And there will be additional changes at that time to make any improvements that we can get with the API, which will make this a lightning fast Google Sites builder. And so thank you for watching Google Sites Factory review. I really highly recommend that you pick this up. Click the link below to get yours today. And thank you for watching YouTube.